Here we meet the men's finalists in the 100 butterfly. In lane one, Metella of France is the man who comes out in lane eight, just 24 years of age. He's in the relay team.
Sadovnikov is in lane number one, Alexander. He's 19 years of age, went to the Youth Olympic Games in 2014 and then the World University Games. So a bit of a non-traditional path, the World University Games. Now he finds himself in the final of the 100 fly.
From the United States, from Huntington Beach, California, is Tom Shields. This is his first Olympic Games. He's looked good. He looked very good in the heats, semis.
Waiting to be introduced. Michael Phelps takes lane number two. His mum Debbie stands, his partner Nicole. And the little man, Boomer. He's becoming quite the personality in Rio.
Yeah, from Hungary. He really needs no introduction to Olympic viewers. Those who followed swimming over the years, Laszlo Cseh, 30 years of age. Hasn't won a medal in this, but he certainly has in other events, including fly and individual medley. Li Zhuhao from China. Out he comes to take his place in lane three. He's 17. Big improver.
Chad Leclos. Already a gold medalist from 2012. He's been in pretty good form here. He loves a race. Finished second in the 200 freestyle. He got fourth in the 200 butterfly here. But this young man from Singapore, he trains out of the USA. He's 21 years of age. He has been so impressive through the heat, the semi-final, and now he finds himself in the fastest lane. It is a pressure to be the fastest qualifier. And it takes a tough, courageous person to handle that pressure of being fastest qualifier.
Particularly when he looks around them as to, you know, who's swimming alongside of them.
Throw into the mix.
Two over, yeah.
You look to your right-hand side, and this man standing there. Now, yeah. Michael Phelps, he's created history by winning a fourth consecutive butterfly here. Oh, sorry, 200 IM. He's now looking to do it again, a fourth consecutive 100 butterfly. He's won three already. No swimmer in the history of the Olympic Games has won four until Michael Phelps came along and did it in the 200 IM. So he's looking to do that again. He has a very strong sense of history and legacy and basically doesn't like to get beaten.
Well, when we look at this, South Africa's won a silver medal. That's it. Hungary haven't won a medal. Singapore, no. China, no. Russia with that one gold from Pankratov back in 1996. The USA, seven gold, five silver, three bronze, including Phelps and Morales and Spitz, of course. But now, the scene is set for more history, possibly, from Michael Phelps in lane two. Schooling's reaction time in the semi-finals was the best by far of everyone, and he starts well again. He's in lane four. Next to him is Leclos, and already Schooling has gone out. Phelps out there in lane two. That Schooling's looking good and right on that world record time.
Phelps doesn't have the same kind of first 50 speed as Schooling, but what we do know is that he'll come off this wall and his underwater will be impressive. It's just how much has the toll of racing taken on his body and whether or not he can mow down a man that's 10 years younger than him.
That is still Schooling. He's transferred the form that he showed in the heats into the semi-finals and into the final, and he's a body length clear almost. Can he hold on? We were hoping to see history in the pool, but we are history because Singapore has won an Olympic gold medal and an Olympic record time. Joseph Schooling, simply sensational.
Equal second for Phelps. Triple way second. Michael Phelps, Chad Laclo, and Laszlo Cher have all got a silver medal. Well, that's unique in itself. But this 21-year-old Singaporean, Joseph Schooling, what a superstar. He trains in the US out of the University of Texas in Austin. Eddie Reese is his coach, who is a legendary US coach. Well, Sergio Lopez is his coach on the Singaporean team. He had the fastest reaction time again, 0.61. Chad Laclo had the same reaction time, but Schooling was incredible under the water. His underwater work was, well, better than Michael Phelps. And then look at this margin, a new Olympic record. His personal best time was 50.83 coming into it. He's gone 50.39. And look at the celebration. I tell you, Singapore, they will be celebrating. They will be in raptures. Well done. Congratulations, Singapore. You have an Olympic champion in Joseph Schooling.
And it's almost as if they've slowly built to this. I love this. He said, who is my hero? Well, of course, it's Michael Phelps. He stands up there and assumes the mantle of Phelps, who is seeking his fourth consecutive gold medal in this event. We were thinking history might come in the form of Phelps, but it's come in the form of Singapore's Joseph Schooling. Phelps, Laclo, and Che all equal second. Synchronized medal presentation.
Except you have to wait for it to be in Portuguese, English, and French.
Yeah. There's one.
Oh, that's brilliant. I've just about seen it all now.
The Hungary continue with their medal haul. They stand third on the table with three gold, two silver, and two bronze. South Africa, Laclo with three silvers, and the US move up with their sixth silver medal. Singapore, gold medal in the pool.
Wow.
He's had the potential.
Yes, absolutely. Their first gold medal in Olympic swimming competition.
And he moved to the US to further his education and training in Texas at Auburn University.
With Eddie Reese.
And he said it's great over there. He loves being in Singapore and returns often. But he said sometimes he's overwhelmed by the amount of attention he gets.
He's going to get a little bit now.
Yeah, even more.
National hero.
A moment to savour for the country of Singapore. And their new sporting hero, Joseph Schooling.
They have a wonderful sports precinct in Singapore. So I can just imagine that this is going to inspire so many Singaporeans to get involved with swimming, but also, you know, if swimming's not your thing, some other sport, but even generally, just to inspire Singaporeans to achieve in whatever they set their goal to.